Graph the function f of x equals negative 2 times the quantity x plus 1 and then times x minus 3. I'm looking at this function, I can see it's in factored form. And the nice thing about this, the factors tell me what the zeros are of the function or the x-intercepts. So what I can do is I can do x plus 1 equals 0. Solve for x, get x equals negative 1. This is a zero product property. Tells me right there, boom, there's a zero. X minus 3 equals 0. Add 3, both sides. X equals 3. There's your other one. You know, this is a quadratic function. It means it's going to be a parabola. But I can tell by the negative 2 that it was vertically stretched by 2 and reflected, so the parabola is open down. Now here's the graphing process you use to finish the graph, and I kind of like this method because it requires a little more problem solving and creative thinking. Notice the distance between the two zeros is 4. Now the vertex has to be halfway in between, which means the axis of symmetry is going to be at a distance of 2 in between. And let me draw that axis of symmetry just to illustrate. That means the vertex has to be on this line right here. Okay, now the question is, well, where's the vertex located? I know the vertex has to be above the intercepts because the parabola is open down, so it has to be somewhere up here. But what you can do is you can use this negative 2 to figure it out. And it's just like the graphing process we used in vertex form. So we have negative 2x squared. Now we know right here that the vertex is 2 away from the 0, or the x-intercept. So negative 2 times 2 squared is negative 2 times 4, which is negative 8, right? Well, that means these zeros, or x-intercepts, are 8 down from the vertex. So thinking backwards, you have to go up 8 and right 2, or left 2, depending on which way you're working. That's where the vertex has to be. So instead of being at the vertex and then going right 2 or left 2 and then down 8, you're just going up 8 and then back the other way to find the vertex. And then if you want to do an additional point, you can do that. Negative 2 times 1 is negative 2. So from the vertex, you can go right 1 down 2 and then reflect that point. And then suddenly you have your points you need to draw the parabola. You can do a third pair of points way down off the grid if you wanted to, or maybe it would be at the bottom of the grid, but I'm just going to base my graph on these guys right now. Okay, so there's our parabola. Let me review the process of graphing when you have a function in factored form. You plot the zeros or x-intercepts first, and then this is a quadratic function, so I know it has to be a parabola. I found the vertex by finding the axis of symmetry, and then using the fact that we have a negative 2 for a coefficient, I work backwards to find the coordinate of the vertex.